Morning, children. The second lesson of the day is the rise of British power in India. Now, children, in the last lesson, we learned the periodization of history and the coming of the British. Now, in this lesson, we will learn how the Britishers who came to India as traders became a mighty power which ruled India for nearly 200 years. Is that clear? Now, you see, the first European to come to India was Vasco da Gama, who came way back in 1498. After that, the other European companies or the countries, whether they were the Portuguese, the Dutch, the Englishmen, they all came to India one by one. They all came to India for trade purposes, and slowly, slowly, they had an impact on the political and economic as well as on the social aspect of India. अच्छा, इस लेसन में हम पढ़ेंगे कि अंग्रेज कैसे एक महान शक्ति की तरह उभरे, कैसे एक महान पावर बने. सबसे पहले 1498 में वास्को डी गामा इंडिया आए थे. उसके बाद दूसरे कंट्रीज आने लगे. डच आए, फ्रेंच आए, पोर्चुगीज आए, इंग्लिश आए, और धीरे धीरे किस तरह से द ब्रिटिशर्स डिफीटेड ऑल एंड वो किस तरह से उन्होंने सबको हराया और एक महान शक्ति बन के उभरे, और ट्रेडर्स से, बिजनेसमैन से वो एक पॉलिटिकल, इकोनॉमिक और सोशल फील्ड में भी उनका वो रहा. मेन रीजन इज व्हाई डिड दे कम टू इंडिया. नाउ हियर यू विल सी, दिस इज द मैप, दिस इज द मैप ऑफ इंडिया. And all the Europeans, they came to India via the sea route and they had their settlements here. Calicut was there, Kannur was there, Cochin is here, Pondicherry is here, Mahe is here, Yaman is here, Masulipattam is here, Vishakhapatnam is here, Calcutta is here, Madras is here. Excuse me. So these are all those places where the Britishers had their settlements. They came via the sea route and they settled over here in the sea coast. This was their domain. Can you see? Because that is why later on also you will see that the English had the best navy. The Spanish also had, of course. That is why they said that the sun never sets on the English Empire, and all the trade was carried via the sea route. All trade was carried via the sea route. Is that clear? So why did they come? You see, this was the phase of industrial revolution in England. And during the industrial revolution, the main ingredient, the main demand was for the raw material. उस समय इंग्लैंड में इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन शुरू हुआ था, यूरोप में शुरू हुआ था, और सबसे ज्यादा जरूरत किस चीज की थी? रॉ मटेरियल की. फैक्ट्रीज तभी काम कर सकती हैं जब आपको रॉ मटेरियल मिलेगा. एट दैट टाइम दे केम टू इंडिया in Asia and Africa in search of raw materials, and these people built factories. Factories were not places where they made goods. Factories were simply establishments. Factories were establishments where it was more or less a godown where they kept their goods, and it also had living quarters for the people who came and settled in India. And another thing is that the Britishers were more attracted to India, first of all, for the raw material, and secondly also for the market of finished goods. Now these people, they took the permission in the 18th century from the British, from the Mughal Empire or from the Mughal government to issue even coins. And slowly, slowly, you see, after Aurangzeb, like you did in class 7, the later Mughals were simply good for nothing. So these people could not do much, they could not achieve much. So slowly the regional governors became independent. Awadh was there, Bengal was there, the Nizam of Hyderabad was there. These people became independent. When they became independent, the Mughal power became weak. ये later Mughals इतने कमजोर थे कि वो कुछ भी नहीं कर सक रहे थे. इसीलिए उन लोगों ने क्या किया, जो governors थे, जैसे Awadh के नवाब थे, बंगाल के नवाब थे, हैदराबाद के निजाम थे, वो सब उन्होंने अपने आप को independent बना दिया. धीरे धीरे जब ब्रिटिशर्स आए, उन्होंने कंडीशन देखी एंड दे स्टार्टेड मेडलिंग इन द इंटरनल अफेयर्स. देन दे अडॉप्टेड वेरियस पॉलिसीज. फर्दर इन द लेसन वी विल स्टडी subsidiary alliance was there, the doctrine of lapse was there, conquest was there, through which they added the Indian territories to their empire. Next, they taxed the people heavily. All raw material was bought at a very cheap rate and shipped to England. That raw material which was shipped to England, then it became very difficult for the local trade artisans and the craftsmen to get any raw material. First of all, no good raw material was there. Whatever was there was at a very high price. So the handicraft industry came to an end, and that was one major cause for the war of 1857. Dheere dheere ye internal affairs mein meddle karne lage, hum aage padhenge kis tarah se subsidiary alliance, doctrine of lapse, conquest, annexations ki tarah inhone apna empire badhaya. जितना रॉ मटेरियल था वो बहुत सस्ते दामों में उसको खरीद लेते थे और उसको इंग्लैंड भेजते थे. इंडिया के क्राफ्ट्समैन के लिए कुछ बचता ही नहीं था. जो बचता था वो या तो घटिया होता था या बहुत महंगा होता था जो वो खरीद नहीं पाते थे. इसकी वजह से हैंडीक्राफ्ट इंडस्ट्री एकदम खत्म सी हो गई. उससे पहले व्हाट द ब्रिटिशर्स डिड वाज दैट दे एलिमिनेटेड द अदर पार्ट्स. द डच वेंट टुवर्ड्स इंडोनेशिया, द फ्रेंच एंड द इंग्लिश वर हियर. The French and the English always fought a war when there was a war in Europe. Slowly, slowly, the French also were defeated. The French were defeated because they did not have any support from the home government. French East India Company ko French government ne koi support nahi diya tha, whereas the English East India Company had full support of the British government. You see, in 1600, the Britishers came to India. There were two representatives, Sir Thomas Rowe and Sir Hawkins. They came in the court of Jahangir. 1600 में सबसे पहले ये East India Company आई और Sir Thomas Rowe और Mr. Hawkins एक आए थे. And they took the permission from Jahangir to set up a factory in Surat. Later on, they had factories in Agra, Ahmedabad and Bhroch. Their first settlement or factory, you can say, was Fort St. George in Madras. And from here, slowly, slowly, then they went to Calcutta. And from there, after one battle after another, which we'll study in this lesson only, Battle of Plassey, Battle of Buxar, that they became virtual rulers of the country. Hum log padhenge kis tarah se 1600 mein Jahangir ke court mein Sir Thomas Rowe aur Mr. Hawkins aaye. और उन्होंने परमिशन ली. क्वीन एलिजबेथ का वो चार्टर लेकर आए थे, क्वीन एलिजबेथ के का लेटर लेकर आए थे. तो उन्होंने को फरमान इशू हुआ, ऑर्डर इशू हुआ. तो उन्होंने सूरत में अपनी पहली फैक्ट्री बनाई. उसके बाद उन्होंने आगरा, अहमदाबाद, भरोच में बनाया. सबसे पहला जो उनका फोर्टिफिकेशन था इम्पॉर्टेंट, वो था फोर्ट सेंट जॉर्ज मद्रास में. धीरे धीरे उन्होंने अपना नेटवर्क बढ़ाया. उन्होंने सारे डच को हराया, पोर्चुगीज को हराया, फ्रेंच को हराया, और सबसे आखिर में उन्होंने फ्रेंच को हराया, क्योंकि फ्रेंच थोड़े मजबूत थे लेकिन उनके पास उतने साधन नहीं थे जितने कि इंग्लिश में इनके पास थे, क्योंकि उनके पास सपोर्ट नहीं था उनकी गवर्नमेंट का. और फिर धीरे धीरे वो दे बिकेम द रूलर्स ऑफ इंडिया. एंड हाउ थ्रू द वेरियस पॉलिसीज दे लिटरली रूल्ड इंडिया टिल 1947. थैंक यू.